Now though, to travel, now, Debbie shimmied into a black rubber suit, really, really gorgeous too, and sat in an inner tube at one of our most famous tourist spots, Waitomo. Good morning, Debbie.
Good morning. You make it sound really weird. Yeah, I mean, Waitomo is absolutely internationally renowned and one of our hands-down family favourite destinations to go. I got to see the caves from an entirely different perspective when I took my English cousin there a few weeks ago, though.
Yeah, it doesn't sound like the usual kind of glowworm tour.
No, it was very, very different. So he's an adventurer, and so I went along for the ride. And I mean, he wanted an experience that he would never forget. So that's what we got. We went to the Blackwater Rafting Company and we went through the Ruakuri Cave. Now, Ruakuri Cave, it's called the Black Labyrinth Tour. It's the original adventure and it's described as beginner level. So we went through Ruakuri Cave, one of Waitomo's most complex caving systems. It was discovered between 400 and 500 years ago, and so you carry your inner tubes through and they actually help keep your balance in the moving water because you're actually wading through water, as you can see, in some places, so your tubes do help with that. Some of the way you're floating along and you're linked up to the person in front of you, you do get to jump backwards off waterfalls just like that. It sounds really scary.
It sounds really scary.
Yeah, let's describe it as adrenaline pumping, and the guides take really good care of you, as you can see. I found that really reassuring, and I mean, some of the caves we just floated through, and the caves were like millimetres from our face. Others, they were metres in the air, and of course, those glowworms, absolutely spectacular. So for part of the tour, you turn off your headlamps.
Wow.
And you're in darkness in this cave, and it's magic. So really well worth doing for that. And I mean, you get a real thrill. We're beneath the hill, if we're going to say. You're going actually under this mountain. So at one stage, you're 64 metres beneath the ground and you look up and you can see sort of a vent at the top. You can see daylight well ahead above you.
Oh, that sounds exciting.
Amazing.
What about temperature-wise? Because it would be a bit freezing?
It was cold. I mean, it was winter a few weeks ago, so it was cold when we were there. The water's about 10 degrees and the air temperature in the cave year-round is about 14 degrees, so we could see our breath in front of us. But you know what? The wetsuits that we were wearing kept us really warm, like surprisingly
good
warm.
Good thick ones.
Good thick ones, double layer, fleece in between. By the end of the 3-hour tour, I was kind of feeling my fingers were a little bit cold.
Yeah.
That was it. For the rest of the time, we're absolutely fine.
So how long have the tours been going for?
Well, the legendary Blackwater Rafting Company has been going since 1987. So this month, they actually celebrate 30 years in operation. They started by driving around Waitomo, back of a ute going with inner tubes on the back going, hey, you want to go caving? And that's pretty much how they started. They're still going hundreds of thousands of adventurers later. I mean, people like Katy Perry's been through, Chelsea Clinton, Peter Jackson, you know, so it's really, yeah, fantastic.
So if you want to do that, but you don't want to be quite as adrenaline pumped, shall we say.
You can totally do that.
Yeah.
So the same caving system, the same company, you can go through the Ruakuri Cave. You walk in through a concrete entrance. The original is actually tapu, so it's not used. So they've built this huge spiral going down into the ground. Fantastic example of engineering. That took 18 months to construct. So you can see that the tour gives you the chance to get really up close and personal with the glowworms. You are face height with these glowworms. You can see the lights and then they shine a light on them and you can see the fishing lines that they each send off to try and hook some food. So glowworms are about the size of a matchstick and you can see them right there. You can see them glowing and you can see those long tendrils coming down. And of course those limestone rock formations are beautiful. And cavers, because they get hungry quite a lot down there, they call them things like streaky bacon and popcorn and cave coral and things like that. So gorgeous. This part of the cave is called the Pretties and you can see why. It is absolutely stunning. At one point you could actually hear a waterfall and it sounded huge. They told us that was the waterfall we'd just jumped off the day before in our tubing experience. So, yeah, it's the same caving system being used for different tours.
It's a little bit sort of less sort of adrenaline. Yeah. How long is that tour?
Well, that one takes 2 hours. And it is New Zealand's longest underground guided tour as well. So well worth doing. You can do this. There are shorter tours that you can do. It doesn't feel like you're underground for 2 hours. That sounds like a long amount of time. But the amount of stories you get about the history and the geology geology. It is well worth doing. Yeah, we had a fantastic time on that tour.
Awesome. So where'd you stay?
Well, we stayed at the Waitomoa Top 10 Holiday Park. Now, this is a goodie, very kid-friendly. Across the road from the cafe and from the general store as well. So when I say kid-friendly, they've got DVDs you can borrow. It's got a really great kids' play area, as you can see. The pool is there. There's a spa pool and a really cool trampoline as well. So it feels very family-friendly, very safe and very enclosed. And the cabins that we stayed in had bunk beds in them. So four kids in one of the rooms and then a queen-size bed in the other. But the biggest hit is the pedal go-karts that the kids got to ride around on. There they go, streaming around the park. And those are the cabins that they're riding past at the moment that we stayed in. So you can see it's really private, really easy. And, of course, the usual sites for camper vans and tents as well. So,
oh, cool.
Yeah, great place to stay.
Sounds absolutely amazing. Sounds like a destination to put onto the bucket list. Thank you so much, Debbie.
No worries.